Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome to Job for the day. If you have iPhone 12 Pro Max or something that you can use to recording 4K 60fps RGLW vision video and you want to edit your video on Premiere Pro, the settings you need to have to export on YouTube is here. This is what I want to show you right now. Okay, get ready. I use the latest version of Premiere Pro. Now this is my project. For example, let me choose another project. This is my project. Look at beautiful. First of all, let me show you something. Come here. Let's take the video from iPhone 12 Pro Max. As you can see, the video is here and you have more information about this here. You can see this is 4K 60fps HDR video. Look at how it looks like.
Good morning and welcome to Job for the day. This is the iPhone 12 Pro Max front camera.
As you can see, it's not a joke. Let me open with another application, another beautiful application like Face Media Player. Look at how it looks like.
Good morning and welcome to Job for the day. This is the iPhone 12 Pro Max front camera. I'm recording this video in 4K 60fps, 12 megapixel front camera. Look at that.
As you can see, this is what I'm talking about. Now, if you want to edit this video in Premiere Pro, what can you do? This is what I want to show you. This is simple. You need to change every settings, okay? Every settings. Okay, start by import your file. Start by import your video. Okay? Beautiful. This is HDR video. HDR video. Let's see more information about this thing quickly with media info. As you can see, it's not a joke. This is what I'm talking about. It's crazy. Let me show you all information about this. As you can see, QuickTime. You can see QuickTime format, QuickTime. You can also use QuickTime on Premiere Pro. Okay, you can see move. You need also this, all of these settings to have the same HDR quality. Okay, you can see the bitrate 55 megabytes. Apple QuickTime. Have here iPhone, okay, iPhone 12 Pro Max, recorded by iPhone 12 Pro Max. You can see HEVC, high efficient video coding. This is Dolby Vision version 1, and you can see this is what I'm talking about. It's about this video, okay? You can see 4K and 60fps, something like that. Okay, minimum frame rate here, maximum frame rate in front of you, 66. Jesus Christ. Now the bit is here. This is a bit 10 bit. This is 10 bit. Okay, 10 bit HDR Dolby Vision. Okay, now you know what you need to know about this thing. Let me show something else. You can see this color primary BT2020 here in Premiere Pro. You need also to remember this because you need to have some information about this. Okay, now let me do something. The first thing you need to do is to go on sequence, okay? Go on sequence and go on this thing. Localize this number, rec 709. This in French, attention English, okay? Localize this thing. This is sequence settings, okay? Now click on this and localize this rec 2100 HLQ. Localize this and select this. This you need first thing you need to do, okay, before editing HDR video from iPhone 12 Pro Max. As you can see, you need to read it and click on OK. Now it's good. Something changed here. All of color here changing. Okay. Before doing this, let me take a picture. Okay. Let me take a picture first and show you the change. You can watch it change everything. Go back to this. Okay. Now, let me take a picture. Okay, picture. Let me look for a picture. Okay, let me take this for no. Okay, let's test this. Put this here. And let me increase the size right now. Wonderful. Can you see this? Beautiful. For example, I have this picture. Okay. Now, let me change the sequence information about the color. Okay. Change everything here. Now, click on OK. Look at what you have here. Look at what you have here. This is HDR. We see here the HDR started. This is what I'm talking about. Go back, look at again, look at the change, look at this is where the HDR taking place. Now let go. This is my video. Okay, go back first to this. Okay, put your video here. You will see the change. This is it. Let me change the size. Okay, 50. This is 4K video. I'm recording 1080p 60 project. Now look at this is my video. Look at the color. Nice. Okay, nice. Now, as you can see, it's nice. Look at this color. Okay, go back on sequence. Okay, settings, change everything. Look at how is it now. Let's see the video where I put here. If the color change, look at, wow, have you seen something change? Beautiful. This is the original HDR. Now I have the original HDR color in front of me, as you can see just here. Let's see this picture quickly. Let's see this picture, how it look like. Look at how it look like. Do you believe this? This is dangerous. Can you see this? Damn. Even this picture is the same picture from this video. Have you seen? Look at how this thing look like. Look at how this video look like. And now let me take a picture here. Let me take a picture here from this thing. And what? Let's see. Look at how it look like. Okay, if you look at the default picture, this is HDR video, picture from HDR video. As you can see, this is what I'm talking about. Okay, so first of all, you need to change this colorimetry, change for rec 2100 HLQ. Okay, now secondly, go on color. When you come on color, what can you do? This is simple. When you come here, you have this sitting. Look at the icon. Click on sitting. And looking for this thing. Looking for this. Rec 2020. Click on this. And it appears here. Okay. Now, if you have this, you need to change for HDR. Okay. I will see the difference. I will see. Now you have HDR. Your video is here and it's crazy. Okay, when you are finished this, what can you do? This is simple. Before you start editing, this is what you need to do. Go on media, CTRL plus M to go on media, okay? Media, okay, export. You have media also here. Now, where can you choose? Where can you choose? Let me show something. Let me show something quickly. Let move. Come here. Okay, this is me. Now, let me show you something quickly. CTRL plus M. Come here. Let me change something. Look at. Look at. This is H.264. Look at. This is the format. Now, when you change this for QuickTime, look at. And you can, as you can see, no grid change here, no grid change here. But you need to fix this. You need to make sure that the color of this video corresponding with this. Okay. Let me talking to you very, very well. Let me talking to you very, very, very well. You need to make sure that the color of the original version here, okay, corresponding to the number 2 here, okay, this can need to come here, okay, this color come here to fix all of this problem, okay. Now let how to do this. This is simple. What you need to do is simple. You need just to, okay, let me take another picture. You need just to change something. Okay, change something else. Let me show you quickly. You need just to change something here. Okay, nice. Now you have this QuickTime. Select it. Now you have this. When you need to choose, you have so many things here. As you can see, when you change, it's not good. It's not take if it what you need to have. It's not good. It's not like what you want. What you need to have is simple. It's here. This image corresponding to this setting, Apple ProRes 422HQHLQ. Now, RG. Now click on this and now look at how it's so similar. Have you seen this? It's so similar. Now you have a good thing. When you change, you can see it's not the same. You need this. Let me test this, for example, not HQ. When you can see, not when you select this without HQ, look at what you have here. Is not the same with this thing. You need to change for this, okay? And now you have what you need. Apple ProRes 422HQHLG. Nice. Now you are ready to export your film. You need just to select your folder where you want to put this. I want to put HDR, okay, iPhone. Okay, iPhone 10 Pro, 12 Pro Max. Great, now save. Beautiful, this is what you need to have to export in HDR and put this on YouTube. And it will take place. To watch this video, you need also a HDR display, okay? HDR TV, HDR display, or something like that. This is what you need to have also. Okay, you can see resources, what you can see, system page. Now Let me see something under nice. Okay, what you have here? Okay, great. Now I have our visitings. You can do nothing. As you can see, we see what you have changed in the sequence settings. Nice. And you can see the color corresponding with this. And what? If you look at the settings, you cannot change the bit rate. Okay. Now it's corresponding directly to the what you have here in the video. Okay, all of this information that I have shown you first. Okay, now you have what the same information here. You have quick time also here. Oh, where are you? You have quick time here, quick time also here. You have move also here. You have all of this for you. Now it's good. You can export your file, you can export your video and enjoy yourself. Are you ready? Get ready. This is my Asus ROG 3G. My computer is in performance and I'm ready to export this file. Before doing it, let me see something. As you can see, this is what? This is Adobe Premiere Pro 2021. Look at nothing, not working. I want now to export this thing. Click on export. You can also click on this, okay, to choose the max settings, the max rendering. But you can see it's changed everything here. It's changed everything here. You need so to like let this like that, and don't change anything here, okay? Don't change anything. Let this like that, and we go. Don't change anything, okay? Now click on what? Export, and we work start right now. Please let me do something. I'll forget something. Let me do something quickly. I'll forget something. Okay. Let me edit very well and quickly this beautiful thing quickly. Okay. Look at this picture. Let me on color. What can I do? I can test all of this. What is this? Now I have this, change the color, all of this. As you can see, this is HDR, bro. I'll edit this to in HDR. Do you believe this? Do you believe this? Wow. Nice. As you can see, it's not a joke. Contrast, okay. Exposition. Okay, nice. You can choose, do what you want easily, just like that. Okay, stop here. Come here. Put that beautiful. Now, this is my video. My video. Let me do something. This is me. Do you want that I add something? I don't know. Now I can edit all of this thing, change the color, everything. I have contrast. Let me go on this, creative, change for this. Look at what you have here. Look at what I have here. Okay, this is natural color. This is what you have when you change. Go back, change, go back, change. Go back. Okay, this is the original version. Okay, no problem. Now, let me go. Okay, look at how this video look like.
Video for the, this is iPhone 12 Pro Max front camera. I'm recording this video with in 4K 60fps, 12 megapixel front camera. Look at that. Do you believe this?
Okay, good. Now Ctrl plus M. I have QuickTime here. You need to change everything here. Okay, let's see if it's corresponding to a video. Okay, nice. Now I need to change everything. Enter test. Okay, HDR. Okay, beautiful. Now I have move, nice, everything beautiful. Okay, also beautiful here, yeah. And nice. Now I can click on export now to finish the job. Now let's see estimate time. Let's see. Okay, what can you see? 2 minutes. Nice. Premiere Pro, where are you? Look at the performance of Premiere Pro. You can see the GPU. I can see. It uses the GPU and the CPU. That's the performance. Nice. Okay, look at what I have here. Look at encode video encoding, information, all of this. And you have 1 minute now, 1 minute. Okay, now beautiful. Nice. Look at, almost finished. You need just to wait. Remember, I use also OBS Studio. OBS Studio is used. Okay, sources use performance of this computer. Also, I can put on turbo mode if I want. Okay, turbo. Okay, this is my Azure 3G and it's good. Now look at what you have here. Beautiful, exporting, finished. Nice. Now let's see more information about the original version of this video. And let's check. And the new one. Beautiful. The new video, look at its size. Look at what you have here. Completely different thing. Look at that. Now let's watch the original video to see how it looks like. Okay, come. What are you doing? What? No way. What are you doing? Damn. Broke it. What is happening here? I don't know. Oh, let me restart this thing. Okay, I also watch the same thing. Okay, I also watch the recording. Now, the video is here. This is the brand new video. Let's see the original version. Okay. Look at the original version with bitrate. Okay.
iPhone 12 Pro Max front camera. I'm recording this video. We're in 4K.
Okay. Let me change the player with something else. Something better. Okay. This is the original version. Okay. Now, let's test the brand new one. First of all, let's see the bitrate. Look at the bitrate here. 56. Here I have now 40. What? 400. What is this? Do you believe this? This size is completely different. This is different size. Look at this, is only 488 megabytes. Here you have 53 gigabytes. Let's open this to see if it's working. Look at that.
Good morning, welcome to Studio 40.
It's so big. So big. So big. Let's see media and more information about this. Okay. I want to see the bit. Okay, as you can see, this ProRes. Okay, bit 2020 or so. And you can see 16 bits. This video that I'm recording here is 10 bits. I don't know why it's 16 bits. This is, I think that this is because of what you have here. Look at 6 bits, maybe. Okay, this is what I want to show you. I also have to like this video and enjoy this video, and I also have this helpful also. Thank you for watching.